There's a file located under PIPC/AF, this AFService.exe.config file, that you use for modifying the connection string that we use to determine how we connect from the AF server to the SQL Server database. Now, it's a standard ADO.NET connection string. There are times when you need to modify this, like, for example, if you ever decide to move your SQL Server database from one computer to another computer, or change the configuration of the SQL Server database so that the instance name changes, for example. Or, for example, let's say that you installed both the AF server and SQL Server on the same machine and then decided to separate them later on. So AF server one machine, SQL Server box on a different machine. You would need to reconfigure this so that we're now going to connect across the network. There's other reasons as well. Sometimes you may want to change the type of security. Integrated security is what we typically see by default. And when I say integrated security, I'm talking about Windows integrated security. Also, sometimes people would like to use the SQL Server security credentials instead of Windows integrated security. So these are all described in this section in your AF User's Guide called Modifying the AF Server's Connection String. So you'll find examples, for example, of using integrated security versus SQL Server security, and changing the different mode, etc. So this would be your first resource when it comes to, you know, learning more about how to change this configuration. Now, so many things of importance are stored in this file for configuration that we do suggest to you impose some security. Either make sure that nobody can log into this machine except, you know, trusted managers, or you can use Windows security to set up a security descriptor for this file so that only certain people can have access to it. And of course, that's a huge topic we're not going to go into right now. So let's take a look at how we would configure this. I'm going to go ahead and right-click on this and open this up with Notepad. Here's the connection string portion of this file. As you can see, these are the different settings. Here's integrated security versus SQL Server security. Let me switch over the word wrap here and see the rest of it. So the server name is right here. Optionally, there's the instance name of SQL Server. It's defaults here to the default instance name. This kind of stuff doesn't change. The database name is PIFD. That's the AF database, the name, the AF application server, that doesn't change. So as I said, there are specific descriptions of the different types of changes you may want to make to this. You'll find this under the section in your AF user guide called Modifying the AF Server's Connect String.